We're glad you're back. Now, time for more Best of Branson.
Welcome back. If you're anything like me, or probably anyone else, when you go to find something to buy, you want something unique. And if you want to think about the word unique, you've got to think about the Grand Village right here in Branson. And here's somebody who can tell us all about it, Pam Critchfield. Always good to see you, Pam.
Hi, Tom. How are you?
I'm doing great. Now, you know, we were talking a little bit earlier, and Grand Village has been here for a little while, almost to the point where, you know, all the folks around here are like family.
We are. It's such a great feeling in this center. Each of the shops has its own unique flavor.
Oh, yeah.
And it looks reminiscent of Charleston.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just meandering little walkways and all kinds of beautiful little boutique style shops. And they're all locally owned and locally operated.
See, that's one of the great things about it. You know you're getting something that it's people who live here, who work here, whose families are here. This is what this village is about. It really is a village.
It really is a village. And one of my favorite things is first thing in the morning,
mm-hmm,
when I come out here to visit the merchants and you see everything opening up and it's got that feel of, you know, them sweeping the sidewalks and them, you know,
yeah,
opening their door and flipping the open, we're open now sign, and it's just something special about it. We have one of the people that I think you're going to talk to later on, or someone is, Mel's with Mel's Hard Luck Diner and,
mm-hmm,
Crinkle Shops and TJ Charleston's. He's been here with us for over 20 years.
Yeah.
And we have a lot of shops that have been here over 20 years. Mulberry Mill, you know, they have samples in Mulberry Mill. I have to tell you, you got to be careful there. You got to be careful there for the samples. You got to be careful at Mel's because he makes the biggest ice cream known to man.
Yeah.
And Sugarleaf Bakery, everything's homemade, and they are known for their cakes and pies and stuff.
Well, on all of that, you see real artisans that are around here at the village.
You know, we're right by the
Engler
wood shop.
Yeah,
Engler's. Peter Engler, famous in Branson. We miss him. He's no longer with us.
Mm-hmm.
But Mary, who worked under his tutelage, runs the shop. And it's wood carvings. And people take home, especially, you know, those little hand-carved Santas around Christmas time. And they collect them. And we're full of things like that. We've got Grand Glitz, which has fabulous clothing,
mm-hmm,
for women and fabulous shoes and boots, which, you know, I seem to be able to partake in that.
A lot of
well.
People like the shoes and boots idea,
Yeah, and we have Corky Shoes, we have, you know, we have the Medic Spa, we have Back in Time Toys. Oh my gosh, Tom.
Oh, yeah.
Those toys are toys you and I remember, and the cool thing is nothing is electronic.
Mm-hmm.
And
you have to play with things.
It
doesn't play by itself.
And there's board games, and there's Tinker Toys, and there's Lincoln Logs.
Stuff that lasts.
Fun. Oh yeah, oh yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And you can even bring old toys in and they'll trade.
Oh.
And we have a lot of people that come here and they end up deciding that they want to send their toys in. They want someone else to enjoy them now.
Uh-huh.
So we have that. We have a tea shop that's second to none. Copper coin lady. Oh my goodness, she has great stories. We have a new gentleman and his wife who opened a jewelry store called Jabot, and he is a veteran. He goes by Sarge, and making this jewelry is actually therapy, and it has helped him so he doesn't have any problems anymore.
Sure, sure.
And you get to know those stories.
Exactly.
And you
and
go see him.
And that's why this is so much like a village. Everybody's kind of pulling for everybody else, and like a village. And I've noticed, you know, people just like to stroll and see what's around, but spend some time here, and just, you can while away time.
Exactly, exactly. Lori's Soap Shop, another favorite. I mean, I spend my money here.
Mm-hmm.
I not only represent the Grand Village, but I spend my money here. I just love it. You know, a lot of people do their shopping on the internet, which I understand that.
Sure, sure, sure.
But when you're on vacation, do yourself a favor, and the locals too. Come out to the Grand Village. Enjoy what it's like to do business with someone that is your friend and is your neighbor.
And it's just what you said. One of the nicest things you can say about, you know, the village is that locals shop here.
Oh, they do.
And that says a big thing. It's, you know, people from here shop here. They know the value, they know the enjoyment, and you can get yourself an ice cream and sit out with an umbrella over you and just while away some time.
It is relaxing. Different than any other shopping center. I've not been to a shopping center like this.
It is unique, as I said at the beginning. Everything is unique.
It was built originally by Silver Dollar City because they had the Rockettes coming in.
Sure.
Grand Palace, which is no longer, but they needed a place for people to see the craftsmen mm-hmm. and things like that in between shows.
And they're all right here at the Grand Village.
Here we are, 20 plus years later.
Tell people where they find the Grand Village when they're coming down 76 Highway.
We are just located in the middle of Highway 76, right next door to what's going to be the hottest new attraction next year, the aquarium.
The aquarium. All right.
So thank you so much for coming and
sure.
visiting
Thanks
us.
Thanks for having us here. You've got to come to the Grand Village. Beautiful shops. It is. It's a village. Come and join the village.
Yes.
Don't go anywhere. The Best of Branson will be right back.